Be he glorified. He is the most rich. To him belongs everything in the heavens and everything on earth. You have no proof to support such an utterance. Do you say about God what you do not know? So obviously in this verse, God is angry with the statement that God has begotten his son. And this is in reference to Jesus.
Yeah.
Because Jesus himself didn't say that he is the only son of God. Jesus said, all the righteous are children of God. And there's a famous verse that says, blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be children of God. And in fact, he said, sons of God. So, all the righteous are sons of God, or children of God, and all the unrighteous are children of Satan. And this is throughout the Gospels, all the four Gospels show that. And this way, do you say about God what you do not know? Now, if we, now that we know the greatness of God, we can see the blasphemy of saying that God has begotten his son. It's like saying you have given birth to a virus or a bacteria. It's so ridiculous. It's not even that. This is just to bring it closer to our mind. Number 69 says, surely those who fabricate lies about God will never succeed. In the Quran, God is very angry with the statement that he has begotten his son. God says the mountains are about to shatter upon hearing this statement that God has begotten his son. But all the righteous being children of God is a more, it's not even appropriate statement, but it's more correct. It's more acceptable. 70. They get their share in this world, and then to us is their ultimate return. Then we commit them to severe retribution for their disbelief. Okay. Then we get to 71. Under the subtitle of Noah. Recite for them the history of Noah. He said to his people, O my people, if you find my position and my reminding you of God's revelations too much for you, then I put my trust in God, and I exhort you to do the following. You should get together with your leaders, agree on a final decision among yourselves, then let me know without delay. So 71 is telling us that everyone who advocates God faces these difficulties. And God is giving us, why is God telling us about Noah? So recite for them the history of Noah. He said to his people, O my people, in spite of my position, am I reminding you of God's revelation? It's too much for you. So this does, it was too much for them. He called them crazy. He persecuted him. All he was doing, in fact, the Quran says that Noah was inviting the people to be forgiven by God. That's what he was doing. I'm asking you, so God will forgive you and to be redeemed by God. So why are you persecuting me? Why are you against me? They considered him an enemy just for doing that.
Same thing.
So it happens all the time with all the people anyone who stands for God. Yes, we are the same human being. Noah had a head and two eyes and a nose and two ears. So the human being, like, he had the same brain. And the people around him have the same brains like the humans around us. So we are the same people.
Mm-hmm.
72, Noah continues, if you turn away, then I have not asked you for any wage. My wage comes from God. I have been commanded to be a submitter. 73, they rejected him, and consequently we saved him, and those who joined him in the ark. We made them the inheritors, and we drowned those who rejected our revelations. Note the consequences for those who have been warned. This is God's system, it will never change. It's been happening, and as you will see continuously, with every messenger, this same thing happens. And you know, even this time, I'm repeatedly reminded from a long time ago, since 1980, that we are in a situation like Noah's situation.
I know, you mentioned
and
that.
And I put it in the perspective also.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So does that mean that the world will be destroyed?
Yes.
It's inevitable
because of the
that.
Disbelievers, yes.
Yeah.
But we still have a long time before that happens.
Okay, if it's that way.
The spirit is the small has to come. And imagine this maybe in 50 years or in 100 years. Yeah. Smoke will envelop the whole earth.
Mm-hmm.
And the people will actually turn to God and will turn to this and they will see the mathematical code. They will believe. And then God will relieve this retribution. The smoke. But they'll go back to their old way. And say 20 more years, 30 more years after that.
Mm-hmm.
Then the big bang. God and my God will come first to invade the world.
And how after?
For 9 years.
After how so many destroy the people, and you know how the generation in the end of the world is, you they say that 70, a lot of people. How if they?
It's going to be then. This will happen now. This a lot of people will believe in the next 10 years. A lot of people.
Okay, and in future that you said that is.
See the this goes in waves. Uh-huh. People believe, and then. The next generation, they become disbelievers.
No, I'm talking about the population. Yeah. If they got the consequence, they're all like the
art. Or destroyed like Noah?
Yeah, yeah, okay. Just a few people, you know, everybody died. And the generation, in the population is with the less, not what you said in the end of the world.
It is not like this kind of flood. For example, think of AIDS.
Uh-huh.
So it's spreading so fast, mm-hmm. it's getting out of hand. And I believe it will not, this is like selective, for example, it starts with the homosexuals. It's like selective destruction
mm-hmm.
of the people who are breaking God's law. When the case of Sodom and Gomorrah, the whole society was corrupt. So God sent the angels and they turned the city upside down.
The whole city was destroyed.
They were all corrupt.
Like uh-huh. in the time of Lut, all the people were bad. So he saved the small group of people that
okay,
were good.
But I mean, it is saved a small group.
Yeah.
And in future, the population wouldn't be.
It doesn't have to be eradication, it doesn't have to be killing. Mm-hmm. We talk about problems, misery, AIDS.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, the believers will be spared all of this. The retribution will hit the disbelievers. Uh-huh.
Okay.
They have problems uh-huh, and misery.
Yes, I know.
Their lives will be made difficult for them.
Yes.
And our lives will be easy.
They'll be retribution. And the believers will be spared just like the believers on the ark were spared and all the disbelievers were destroyed.
Okay. My question is if the all disbelievers destroyed.
No. They will not be destroyed. They will be suffering.
Suffering.
The
not
retribution.
The Oh, is that? Oh, okay. Yeah.
And also the population is so much more.
That's why the population is more than now.
Yeah, much more.
Oh. Oh, when you say it is like Ark of Noah, and you say it, doesn't mean that all of them, they die.
Not dead, no.
Not dead, okay.
They suffer.
Yeah, because always it was my question. If it's, you know, we
are... Now we ride the jet plane and travel back to Iran and visit our people.
Wow.
See, we need the fax machine, mm-hmm. we need the telephone, the jet, the airplane, we need these things to serve spreading the message.
Okay, yes, I
know. In other words, if that destroys the United States, for example, then how are we going to spread the message? You know, so we need, these things are needed to spread the message and to pick out the believers mm-hmm. everywhere in the world.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I sent the fax machine to Indonesia, for example, and people, the believers over there. And mm-hmm. so we need this stability,
mm-hmm.
and we need all these economic advances, and we need the people. But the believers will be spared any retribution.
Okay. I understand that.
Mm-hmm. Let me clarify it. Sometimes we do need to clarify it.
Mm-hmm.
Humans insist on their original sin. This is 74. Then we sent after him messengers to their people. They went to them with clear proofs, but they were not to believe in what they had rejected in the past. We thus see the hearts of the transgressors. You understand this?
Mm-hmm.
This has to do with what we're talking about this morning. They were not.
I got to explain when he's sitting.
They were not to believe in what they had rejected in the past, billions of years ago.
The blasphemy.
Yes.
They made a mistake. The mm-hmm. great crime. That's what he's talking.
This is why I put the subtitle, humans insist on their original sin.
Yes, we made the mistake of not believing God.
Why is it that the majority of disbelievers, if you go downtown Fremont, the vast majority of people are oblivious to God. They have no idea who God is or what.
No, they believe in one God. They tell you there is God. God does this. But then they don't really do anything about it.
Yes. Just lip service. It's called lip service.
Just lip service.
So, but the reason is that these are the rebels. We, you and I and all those humans, we are the rebels. So, it is the rule to be against God. It is the exception to believe in God and devote ourselves to Him alone. We are the exception. We are not the rule.
MashaAllah.
And before, not now, alhamdulillah,
you know, 2-3 years ago. I thought all the time that he says that, but they were not to believe in what they had rejected in that in the past. I thought they talk about the parents. The parents reject the past that we are same. But
no, this is us.
This is us. Each one of us is responsible for ourselves. Yeah. We committed the sin and we are subsequent. And I find that the majority of people, they have this feeling that if they are good to the poor people, do a lot of good work, talk nicely to everybody, and they are good human beings, that they will never go to hell. They have no concept of heaven or hell.
The prerequisite is to believe in God.
I know, but they don't believe in that prerequisite. And they think that if I tell that to them, if I tell somebody, you know, your first prerequisite is belief in God. Mm-hmm. After that, even if you commit murder, that belief in God might take you at least up to lower heaven.
Yes.
But if you...
Well, even the higher heaven.
They don't have belief in God. But if they don't do good things at all.
No. Many people are there. Yeah. I know so many people in the hospital. The person I got the laser from, Sandy, is such a nice person. Oh, Dr. Kedney, Dr. Kedney, he's all around. You know what I'm saying? He's the best person. I mean, he takes me out to lunch and he talks nicely. I am just dying. So I bring the book and I talk. He's paying for the lunch and the talk. Then he told me, oh, no, Dr. Kedney, please don't keep on talking about this to me. I don't believe in God. See what a nice person I am.
Yeah.
He's rich, he's well off, he has a good wife. He does nice things to people. If somebody is poor, he will give them money. He's a good son, he's a good husband.
Yeah.
But he's an atheist. He doesn't believe in God.
Okay.
Sandy is a nice man.
Okay, if they are nice and they don't believe in God, because God says that their work is like nullify their work. Because God says everything that you do, I pay.
Yeah.
And they get in this life. If they are good, they get in this life.
They get in this life.
But when you get a nice life, because the life is not.
This is right, good. Rasha.
They get things here in this
life. Yeah, but when
because they are nice,
and God says nothing, doesn't mean that if you do good things,
you understand?
You don't get good things. You get good things here.
Right.
But when God says nothing, because the life is nothing.
Yes.
Yeah, right?
Yes.
Do you understand,
Andy? Yes. No,
they don't believe
the
in afterlife. But they are being nice in this life. So God is nice to them in this life.
Yeah.
But afterwards, since they don't believe, they are still going to be in hell. But they lead a good life in the meantime.
Yeah.
Because they have been nice
to them. Well, it happens automatically. When he is born into the hereafter, he is born with a baby soul that was never nourished, never developed.
Yeah.
So he cannot stand the presence of God.
Right,
and they have to run away from God.
I know a lot of people like that. Yeah. Very educated people.
The best majority.
I have the chief of pulmonology at the hospital, Wayne Mall. He's a very fabulous doctor. And he sat with me and he told me, okay, now you explain to me about creation.
Mm.
And he said, he's a Christian, a good Christian. I told him everything. And I said, Wayne, you know, you have to understand. And he said, yes, I understand everything. But then after I finished, he said, oh, what a bunch of baloney. And then I told him, okay, don't believe me, I will give you the book to read. He said, okay, I will read the book. So I left the book to him. He read the book, everything. He brought the book back in a week. And then he told me, you talk better than the book.
Probably.
He said, let's go out to dinner and keep talking to me, but I don't want to read this book anymore. I said, forget it.
Did he read anything in it?
He read. He read the book. He's an intelligent man.
Yeah.
He's very highly educated.
One week, he read the whole book.
I can read this book in 3 days if I want to.
Yeah, but
he did.
I don't think.
But he is not, you understand where he's coming from.
Yeah.
But he is an intelligent man.
It has nothing to do with intelligence.
No.
Yeah.
It's really a gift from God. Okay, let's go back. Yeah. Moses and Aaron, 75. When I finish this page, and then maybe go. What time is it?
9 before 9.
Moses and Aaron, 75. Then we sent after them Moses and Aaron to Pharaoh and his group with our miracles, but they turned arrogant. They were guilty. When the truth came to them from us, they said, this is obviously magic. Moses said, you describe the truth when it comes to you as magic? How can the magician succeed? They said, did you come to divert us from what we found our parents doing? And to attain positions of prominence for yourselves, we will never believe with you.
how many colors.
See, people are people are people. They're all the same.
Yeah, all the same.
Yeah, so I think we'll quit here.
Look at here, how many colors?
Yes.
Different.
Yes. Whose pen is this? Can I take this pen with me?
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you. So, are you coming to Muhammad's meeting or Parivash's meeting or both?
I don't know. What shall I do? I mean, I'm not.
I'm already.
And this very long number is a multiple of 19.
This can you believe that? That's a multiple of 19?
Okay, now listen to this. If instead of the number from here to here, now all these are physical facts. All you need to do is prove that it is not divisible and all my work is zero. It's not interpreted. I'm not saying that, in my opinion, this number is a lot of 19, but it is. It's a physical fact. It's not anybody's conjecture or opinion. So if you put the Sura number, the number of verses, and the geometrical value of every letter in the Sura, 139 numbers, next to each other, and you put them here, instead of the asterisk, you now have a very long number, which is the number of every Sura, the number of verses, the number of every verse, and the geometrical value of every letter, all the way to the end. And you do it here, replace this with it, we end up with this number. I think it's 4,623 digits. The number of digits in the number is 4623 or 6423. I may have it in my briefcase, but it is 6,000 to 4,000 plus, and it's a multiple of 19. That's the number of digits, and the long number is also a multiple of 19. Okay, now if you add the geometric value of every verse, so the first verse is 786, instead of the value of every individual letter, the number of digits becomes 760, which is also a multiple of 19, and the long number is also a multiple of 19. It is really too much.
Rashad, yes. Sometimes so happy that I know you because I know if I follow you, I am going to go to heaven. Sometimes I am scared because I know if one of us that I know this miracle and if reject, you're going to be first person in the world is going to go to hell.
Yes. The difference. In the Hasara, the same Quran.
The 19th curse for the believer and the
blessing
for the believer.
Yeah. See, we have now this very powerful.
And enclosed.
Thank
you. But now.
This is a very simple surah, just one surah with seven verses. Yet the mathematical structure appears to be a physical impossibility. Then what is, just look at this number here.
I have to bring another paper.
I don't need any more. This number here is right from right to left to left to right, and it's a multiple of 19. It's a very, very long number.
But is the way to do that, if we have to offer that something there, 2, 4, 4.
Exactly. I'm glad you mentioned that. Look at this number here. The morning prayer is 2 units. The noon prayer is 4.
Yeah, this is.
And the afternoon is 4, the sunset is 3, and the night is 4. This is about the 19. So, in the simplest form, it pins down the number of units per prayer. It's also the amount of 19. 2, 4, 4, 3, 4. And in this sequence,
and the total is,
you cannot change the sequence. And you cannot make this 4 or 2. You cannot make this 4 or 2. You cannot play with any number.
Okay, Rafa, when you divide this number by 19,
yes.
If the result is when you add up them, the number is 17.
Which one? Yes, yes. 2, 4, 4, 3, 4.
Yeah,
Yes, what's the number?
You understand that?
Yeah, yes, I do. Let's do it now. 24 by 19 is 1. We have 5 left.
1, 2, 3, 6.
2, and 53.
Yeah,
1, 2, 8, 6. It's 1, 2, 8,
6. Yeah. You add this up, you have 17.
If you divide 1, 2, 8, 6 by 19, it is 17.
That's the number of records.
Which is also the number of the first surah and the number of verses in
it. Oh, mashallah. Can you believe?
Nice. Well, good. So God,
I like telling you, my goodness.
Nice.
I can't believe this.
So what the people have for this?
The Zuma prayer, we all pray for us.
By the
We are working on it.
Yes.
This, it might be still the minute, what we found out. It might be so many, miracles.
Yes, Quran.
Yeah, there are so many miracles in the Quran. It is one of, it's a bit. It's a start.
Yes. No, but this is only a very minute. This is 1 million to it.
Yeah, of
course. You have to read Appendix 1 in this book. Shakira, I'm going to use the last piece of paper.
Thank you. Rashad, of course, we know if you bring here all the leaves of the tree as a paper, it is not enough. The whole seed is finished by writing. Only the tarif, only the tarif of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah, Priva, you have a
new one. Karima has one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good prepared.
Karima.
Amir. Look at the Amir's son. You have a green board for
Karima. I have a white book. A white paper.
Yeah, that too. Bring it too.
And yeah, I'm very green board.
So this is a red sacrifice. This is the plant of my house. No, I don't think it would be. No. That's why I keep them here. They might. I just want to share with you something else that's very interesting and it reflects what we were doing. Because only a few years ago, we were doing everything wrong. I don't know how it is in Iran or some other place, but in most Muslim countries, yes, I'll deal with you in a minute. In most Muslim countries, if you pray, in fact, here in America, if you go to any mosque and pray behind any imam, you will never hear Bismillah Rahman Rahim. Is this true? You never hear. And at the end of Al-Fatiha, you hear Ameen. Long, very long. If you go to Mecca, for example, you use Mecca as an example, you never hear Bismillah Rahman Rahim behind the imam. Never. I've been there quite a few times. And after Al-Fatiha, you hear a very long Ameen, which is it's not an Arabic word, it's not a Quranic word.
What does it mean exactly, Ameen?
This is Satan's word. This is Satan's word, as I'm going to show you now. What Satan did, we were doing this. I was doing this 20 years ago. Everything we were doing was wrong. This is God's blessing on us. And if you read Surah 65, verse 11, God says He's sending a messenger to lead the believers who are righteous out of darkness into the light. I mean, we were believers, and we were righteous, but we were doing everything wrong. And then God, out of His mercy, sent to us all these corrections. So I want to share with you what the Muslims are doing in most countries. And I'm going to use Mecca as an example. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, the grammatical value is 786. Most of us know this, right? See how big it is? So they remove that. Minus. Pardon? Yes. Even without that. Shakira always likes 786 and every reference to that. They remove Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. We never hear. And they add Ameen. Ameen is 102. Plus 102. Now this is Satan's system to remove the name of God. In fact, in the last issue of the perspective, I reproduce a copy from the books of jurisprudence saying that Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, my hair stands up. Listen to this. They call it makruha. Satan. The name of God. This is in the books of Sharia. The books of jurisprudence. This is why they do not say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Now, they don't really mean to say that it is hated. But they set up the practices as
I'm sorry.
It's alright, we're waiting for you. In the books of jurisprudence, they divide the duties of the Muslim into fard, which means obligatory, wajib, which means duty, sunnah, which is maybe you can do it, makruh, which you better not do it, and haram, means forbidden. So it just happened that way. So when they came to Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, it fell under the category of makruh. Without realizing it, Shaitan made them say that the name of God is hated, makruh. So they do not say this and they add Ameen, 102. You're going to miss the punchline. What is the net result of this?
You sent me this already, I know it.
Oh, okay. Huh? What is not?
No, it's
not. The product is 684. This is 684, it's 119. You know what it is? Al Quran al Kareem. This is the grammatical value of Quran. And this is minus. So they use the Quran.
Minus the Quran.
Yes, 684.
Six is the grammatical value of
minus Bismillah plus Ameen, 102. It's exactly the value of the Quran. When you lose the key,
Allah.
Wait, you haven't heard anything yet. When you lose the key, you can't enter, can you? You
see, enter the Quran. While the Imam is now offering the prayer, he must be saying Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
No, he doesn't. In fact, I went to them and I asked a number of them. I said, why do you say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim? This is the most important verse in the Quran. He said, I say it secretly.
Secretly, not in the Quran.
But you see, the way they do it is prove that they don't say. He just said this, but I said it in a secrecy, just to answer me, because I was bugging him, or just to send me away. He said, I say it secretly. I said, no, you don't, because you say. And I tend to say that Allahu Akbar, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alam. So there's no time to say secretly or loud. I have recordings of their prayer. The Allahu Akbar, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alam.
Without niyyah, we cannot start prayer like that.
No, then he does the niyyah and A'udhu Billah and everything. Then he starts the prayer saying Allahu Akbar. And then immediately, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. So they don't say it here.
Could you please repeat that again?
That was
Zibash. Do you understand it?
You don't understand it? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. You don't hear it when you pray in Mecca or in most mosques. You don't hear it at all. Satan talked them into canceling it. The geometrical value of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is 786. So it's minus 786. And they added the end. Only Satan did that. You have this non-Quranic word, Ameen, which is 102. So, minus 786 plus 102, the net result is minus 684, which is the value of the Quran. And it's a lot of 19. So, what God is telling us is, they lose, when they lose the key, they lose the whole Quran, they have no access to the Quran. Did you hear anybody say the Quran is very difficult?
Now
God says, I made the Quran easy.
It is so easy.
And God repeats it. But it is easy for the believers. It is impossible for the disbelievers.
It was difficult for me 4 months ago. Now it is very easy.
Now, do you remember the verse of the Quran that says, how come they do not understand the Quran? Do they have locks on their hearts or minds? Yeah. أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أطفالهم؟ طفل أو أطفال الدكتور اللطيف نفس الفاسي وصل؟
Really؟
उनके दिलों में उनके दिमाग में
क्या ले रही हो? Alright.
The pronunciation is different.
Now, what is the name of that surah? The key.
The key.
We have key and tip.
So that is the key. Al-Fatiha is the key. So you need to open that lock. I'm sorry.
So that.
I didn't mean the difficult, I mean to say the depth of Quran, you understand.
No, but see, God made it easy, and He repeats it many times. وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ I made the Quran easy, I made the Quran easy. And in many other places.
When she started the Quran, she didn't know even English and no Arabic, not even English. And she's mashallah.
Didn't look Japanese to you. What's your question?
Again?
These are the 17 units of contact prayers that you are required to do every day. We do 2 in the morning, 4 in the noon, 4 afternoon, 3 in the afternoon, and 4 at night. But the number of 17 is probably significant because it has the number of the first surah, the key, and the number of verses in it, 1 and 7, 17. Also, we have a special prayer in the week that is 2 units. If you add that to 17, you got 19. So,
on Friday we do 2.
Minus 4, the first is gone. So the first is gone. But the lady is there?
No. Yes. No. That's the total number. By the way, if you...
I'm telling you.
The number of verses next to 786, we have a multiple line here.
But I do 2 footers. That's
2 footers. 2
footers,
that is it?
It is very...
And 2 footers as well?
Why?
That's a lot.
Put 1 next to it.
I do
2,786
You are not offering the 4 after the rules.
No.
That's it. That's something.
Yes.
So now we have mathematical proof for the number of rak'ahs and what to say. You know, we used to read the Quran after Al-Fatiha.
Yeah.
But you're not supposed to do that. Because this will destroy the mathematical structure. And the,
this means that the first page again?
Did you hear? No.
They didn't hear it.
This flood of miracles is coming because I'm working on the new constellation. Surah 1.
You know, I think you should also talk about Millat Ibrahim, because even without this, mashallah, we already had proof because of the Millat Ibrahim. Can you tell?
Because the
salams are not mentioned specifically in the Quran, but before that we are supposed to follow the religion of Abraham.
Right.
So we already know that is what we have to do.
Right. The prayer came to us through the Prophet Ibrahim. It was practiced before the Prophet Muhammad. And the universal acceptance is a sign that it was, the number of units was correct. But we were at a loss as to what exactly should we say in it. Because people are reading Al-Fatiha and then reading Qul Huwa Allahu Ahad. Inna Atanaka Al-Kawthar. But then when you think about it logically, when you read the key, you are saying, Iyaka Na'budu Wa Iyaka Nasta'in. Only you will worship, only you will ask for help. So, obviously while we're speaking with God, we're calling God, only you, God, we worship. Only you, we ask for help. And then we turn around and say, Inna Atanaka Al-Kawthar. We give you a lot of bounty. It doesn't make sense. So it's only the key that is required.
You worship, we worship. What we worship, you do what you want.
Yeah.
The meaning of closer.
These are among all the innovations that were added in 1400 years. There's too many innovations. And it is God's mercy that He's helping us remove all these now. What we're doing here is take Islam to the original Islam, the way it came to the Prophet Muhammad. Consolidate and purify. So the two key words.
A while ago, we were talking about Jesus Christ. Somewhere in Quran it says that before we die, we have to believe in Him too. Is that true? Or I'm wrong?
Yes, of course. You know, we have to believe in all the messages.
All them, not only Him. All the messengers.
You believe the Salah.
One verse.
Yeah, but they say why, especially Jesus. God says that you have to believe in Jesus before you die.
You mention
the special name of Jesus.
Well, like any other
messenger. So there is no difference.
No.
What is that verse and Surah?
We have to believe all the messengers.
Yes.
You don't remember.
Yeah. If God tells you that Salah is a messenger, do you believe him?
Yes, sure.
So?
No, but I mean, in that particular verse,
does not, when you say something specific, does not exclude anything else.
Yeah.
Like the people who say, do not go to the prayer drunk means drink every other time. It's not the, it's not.
Yeah, but what about the drink? So is it haram by Quran?
Yes, absolutely.
Which is which verse?
Quite a few. In Surah 5 verse 91, for example, it's a straightforward command not to come close to gambling and alcohol.
Come close.
It's a very strong prohibition. This is what God told Adam and Eve. God told Adam and Eve, don't come close to this tree. Look where we are now.
Still we are. We are enjoying it. It's alright.
Pardon?
It is alright.
What is alright?
We are still enjoying in this world.
I don't understand.
Well, in this world, the God has created this world for Adam and Hawa, and they are enjoying this world.
No, but this is a curse. This world is bad, you know, it's not. It is better to be
a bad. This is the place where Moses, Prophet Muhammad, this sort of Nabi has come, Rasul has come. How is this curse?
Oh, it's very bad. This is a very bad world. See, we are now in the larva. We're in the larva fold.
You see, sir, the people eating the meat here, which is not killed in the name of God,
yes.
That is haram, absolutely.
No.
Have you got the meat in the safari market?
You can eat the meat from the market. I told you not to.
How can we eat? In the Quran, the verse says, only we can eat the meat which is killed in the name of God.
No, don't say, it said do not eat meat that is dedicated to other than God. There's a difference. Okay, it gives you four meats that are specifically prohibited in the Quran.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, animals that die themselves without human interference.
Not anything.
That's haram.
That's the meat which is not killed in the name of God.
No, wait.
Other than God.
Yes, dedicated to other than God. You have to watch the words. Because this is very important. Because God makes this disobedience of the dietary laws tantamount to idol worship, because there's some other God who told us something else. Okay, so let's go. These four are consistently prohibited in the Quran. Number one, animals that die of themselves. Number two is running blood, which is put in a glass.
Yeah.
You can't drink it or cook it or anything. Number three is the meat of pigs. Number four is animals dedicated to other than God. So what you do in the safari market is you stand in front of the meat and ask, did this animal die without human interference? No. Is this meat of pig? No. Is it running blood? No. Was it dedicated to Jesus? No. Therefore it is okay. It doesn't belong in the fourth category.
Put it in your mouth and take it to heaven.
But you, when you eat it, you mention the name of God on it.
Why do we halal it? What is the halal?
That's another innovation. It's halal. Unless it is one of these four, it is haram. These four are haram. Nothing else.
What else is haram?
Alcohol, gambling, the whole bunch, adultery, murder, drugs.
You should tell her if jackpot is okay or not. 25 cents jackpot.
Haram.
But the loves, about the liquor, about the wine, about the spirit, the word haram, like for the swear, like for the food, blood, being used by Quran, it is not being used for sharab.
Use the word
haram.
Prohibited.
It is, you see, it's a different category.
No, there are many, many different words used to prohibit things. Like I said,
I understand, but here as Ram means Jews, like Sura, however, like Sura, that sort of things, which is God has used and
fire. But God uses the strongest prohibition when it comes to alcohol and gambling. God uses the strongest prohibition in the Quran.
That I like it, it says strongest prohibition.
But God says, not
haram. The reason I'm here from you also, the word is so important to us. This is how we think about it. But there are other words that is much, much.
It's my thinking. You see, being a Muslim, many Muslims are drinking.
No, I'm sorry. No. Let me finish my point. My point is, this word to you and to us is very strong, haram. But he's saying there are other words that are much stronger than haram that we don't know.
Yeah.
But all we know, the word haram.
I can repeat it for you. God calls alcohol and gambling in Arabic rijsun min amal al-shaytan. It is an abomination and the work of the devil. So it is very, very strong prohibition. Very strong haram. In 591. And then he says, Fashtanibu, you shall avoid them. That's a commandment from God. And then the choice is ours in the end. I can still drink if I want to and if I'm willing to pay the price. Excited from God. Eternal hell.
In the early days of Islam, the people used to come for the prayer.
Repentance repentance is not accepted from those who sin until the death comes to them. Then they say, now I repent. Specifically, the Quran says that.
Excuse me, the one thing that's haram also is for the, if he's initiated in the Nazar, sacrifice the animals in the name of Abul Fazl. It's very common in my country, Abul Fazl.
That is haram.
This is
haram.
Yeah.
Absolutely, Niyaz, Nazar, haram.
Yeah, Moshe. Well, because it is Shia, he said. But the Shia says the same to the Sunni community.
Shia, so they are doing Nazar and Niyaz, but we don't do this sort of thing. Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the question is the same as the same one. This is something that I've been thinking about the past few years. Basically, every time we talk about the things that we do, like praying and charity and all those things, and it's to grow, we improve our soul, we increase our soul. Mm-hmm. God doesn't put anyone in the house.
If maintained until death.
And anything else, I haven't seen this. Like, if you do good things, you improve, or if you don't do good things, you stay the same. If you do bad things, you improve, it becomes smaller.
Yes, no, yes. Like yes, the Quran says that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It says there is a rule in the Quran that says, Inna al-hasanat yudhibna al-sayyat. Do you understand this? You can say it in Arabic? Parivash? Can you translate this? Inna al-hasanat. Yudhibna sayyat.
In English, Farsi.
Any way you want.
I said, Parehu, Parebadu, and Dubrom. And Parebadu, yeah. Anything you do the righteous and good things, disappear the bad thing, the thing.
Right, so there is a plus and minus. You balance each other.
So basically, the bad things they do.
They will reduce your credit, and your credit will reduce the discredit. It's just like accounting, plus and minus.
Rashad, even though if you drink alcohol, and give charity, it's going to be plus minus?
Yes, you drink alcohol, your soul will shrink, and give to charity, your soul will grow.
So you say the same thing.
Not necessarily.
No, because they're going to use the alcohol. You can't share it indirectly. So, if you can discover
if yes, you can be ahead. You can always be ahead. Nobody can live a sinless life. Nobody can live a sinless life. So, but it's the end result. However, in the end, everything must be forgiven. Then, 100 times a day. Yep. Sure. Good for you. God says God loves those who continuously repent. If you pass by somebody and you make an face and you hurt their feelings, you got to repent. For example.
You have to
be ignorant that it is haram. Let me read the two verses for you. Surah 3. God says repentance is accepted from those who fall in sin without out of ignorance and then repent immediately upon knowing that it is a sin. So that's when repentance is accepted. However, if you know that gambling is haram and you gamble, no, that's haram. Very bad. You said that the creators who insisted on seeing a demonstration whether Satan can make it or not.
Uh-huh. More clever than me.
So now God's plan begins here.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
God gathered them in a conference, okay? It was a conference, and God told them, you bear witness that I am your Lord. Do you bear witness that I am your Lord? And we all said, we bear witness, we know it, it's a fact, you are our Lord. Then God put them all to death.
Mm-hmm.
This is now, because God said, I'm going to bring you in another life where you have no recollection of this.
Okay.
You don't remember anything here.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to send you on a spaceship Earth.
Okay, excuse me.
Far away.
But when they say, yeah, we are witness that you are our Lord.
Yes.
Before we die. Okay, that means that we repent.
No. It's a statement of fact.
Oh, a statement of fact.
God says, because this will be instinct in us.
Uh-huh.
So he said, we're going to send you to the planet Earth with this message. That I alone am your Lord. Because God told us. And then Satan is going to tell you, give you his message on the earth.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And you're going to make a choice between these two.
Yeah.
You either choose that God alone is your master, or that another entity like Satan can also have authority, like Jesus, Muhammad, Moses, the saints.
Yeah.
So this is
This
is the choice, that God alone or God and some other entity. Okay. God alone is the message of God that he gave us here in this conference. God and somebody else like Muhammad or Jesus or Mary or saint is Satan's message.
Okay.
What Satan is telling us, God alone is not enough.
We need help.
Yes. God has assistance, Ali and Muhammad. And so.
God is so bad.
Yes.
God needs
help. Okay, now these creatures were all put to death. These are jinns and humans. Jinns and humans. They're put to death. And then God on the planet Earth created the body of Adam. This is the body of Adam, made from clay. And then God picked out one of these guys here to be assigned to this body. And he put him, God created heaven or paradise. And he put Adam here in paradise. All these creatures are dead. And created Eve also from Adam, cloned her from there.
Why he created Adam and Eve? Because
this was the beginning of the plan. His name? We're trying to find the sequence of creation.
Okay, so Adam and Eve.
So God put in us the instinct that only God is our Lord and Master. Okay? and then put us all to death, humans and jinns, and then created the body of Adam and the body of Eve here on earth,
mm-hmm.
and put them in heaven, but they were connected, the soul was connected.
And we were all still dead.
Yes, all of us were dead.
Now why did he have to create Adam and Eve to create another mistake? That's an allegory.
No. What do you mean another mistake?
I mean, we already committed two mistakes. Now this is the third mistake they committed.
Yeah, but you see, God wants to show us how fair. No, it's not to show us. God is very fair and just. Okay, mm-hmm. And He wants us to. We make the choices. God does not want robots. In fact, this rebellion here, the purpose of it, one of the most important objectives, is to show all God's creatures that we have the freedom of choice. We will never know it if Satan did not rebel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You follow me?
Yes, yes. I follow.
Okay. So, God created the fire, mm-hmm. and He gave us the choice to use it to cook.
Yeah.
See in the kitchen? Yeah. We're using it to cook.
Yeah.
But also, if you put your finger in it, it will burn.
Yeah.
So, we can use it to hurt ourselves. But we have to make the decision to put our finger in the fire.
Mm-hmm.
Or to use it.
Mm-hmm.
Cook. So, here's Adam and Eve in paradise, and God gave him a law. Do not eat from this tree.
Mm-hmm.
Any time they listen to Satan, they will go with Satan.
Mm-hmm.
As long as they listen to God, they'll be in God's kingdom. So they were in God's kingdom.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Satan came to them and said, if you eat from this tree, God forbid you from eating this tree because you will live forever
mm-hmm.
in here. And they listened to Satan. The minute they did that, they were sucked directly into their bodies.
Mm-hmm.
And their bodies became visible to them. You remember those verses in the Quran?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But when they listened to Satan, they exposed a human flaw. They were representing all of us. We were all here.
Mm-hmm.
But the fact that they listened to Satan
mm-hmm.
showed that this is a human flaw that is in all of us.
Mm-hmm.
That we will listen to Satan sometime. So.
It's good they rebel because otherwise we'd still be dead.
That's one way of looking at it.
Otherwise there won't be Shakira.
Yeah.
In another, we can say it, all of genetic.
Yes.
All genetic.
Genetically, we were all in Adam.
Yeah.
All of us were in Adam.
That's right. That is the allegory. Okay, now it is a better understanding for me.
Yes.
You understand now?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. All of us are genetically represented in Adam and Eve. That is
absolutely
the allegory.
Yes. Yes. In Adam and Eve,
all the women are represented by Eve. And all the men are represented by Adam.
Why
it's not
God make so many languages?
Only one soul.
No.
To make
he
life
picked up one soul, yes. But that soul represented all these dead
lot
souls.
Interesting to people.
Who rebel.
Yes.
Like there's so many
and
fruits,
so it is as if we all
rebel. Variety of color, variety of
that. It's also one of God's powers.
No.
It's a very strange thing that you can speak in Hindi,
mm-hmm.
Everybody
speak
in Arabic.
So when Adam rebelled, all the men rebelled. And when Eve rebelled, we all rebelled.
Mm-hmm.
That
then
is
Hindi
the allegory. But
Hindi?
To make it easier for people to understand.
What is this in Hindi?
Cup.
Cup. English cup, but in Hindi.
In Hindi?
Pyaani.
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 I would say Finjan.
Finjan.
See, I say Finjan, you say Piali, but we understood the same
but
thing.
But the languages
this
are created
power.
By human beings.
No.
Only
God gave them the capacity to create.
Yeah.
But everything is God.
Look, we're speaking
God
in English.
Creation.
Yes.
But,
what is the cup in Japanese?
Cup.
Huh?
Cup.
Oh.
Cup.
English.
Well, we call it.
Cup.
Huh?
Oh, I see. It comes from English.
Yeah.
We need something Japanese.
We have
okay, what is book in
and
Japanese?
Everything
home.
We do,
home.
What you're talking about. Why are you sitting here?
Okay,
because
book.
God wants you to listen.
See,
okay.
The book in Japanese is home. In Arabic, it's kitab. In Hindi?
Kitab.
Really?
Sorry.
Sorry.
So many.
We trying to get away from.
No, but glasses.
Yes.
Glasses.
Glasses.
Einak.
Okay.
We said einak.
Einak. In Hindi. Wow, look at this. There's all of something in common.
R is Japanese. There is one origin. They all come from that origin. That
One is a parent language and then
also there is mixing of the languages.
Yeah. Yeah, India too. Like Persian and Urdu are so many languages, but the origin of all those languages is Sanskrit. That's why so many words will be common.
I think in India, I hear the word dunya.
Dunya is world.
Right. It's in Arabic also. So there's also mixing of the languages. Yeah. But the language is fantastic.
Egyptian either.
Nazara
means eyesight.
Yes, yes. In my language. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So you guys can understand each other?
Many words.
Mm.
Okay. Now Adam and Eve started to have children.
Yeah.
Every time a child is born, one of the souls is assigned to that child.
I understand perfectly.
Yes, so that's the sequence.
Actually, now I am going to do this now. I am going to say that in Adam and Eve, all of us are genetically represented.
Yes.
So Adam and Eve didn't make the mistake. We all made this mistake again.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Right?
Repeatedly. Oh,
yeah. Adam and Eve didn't do mistakes.
No, no. We are genetically represented. All the women in Eve and all the men in Adam.
Hmm.
So when Adam made the mistake and Eve made the mistake, we all made the mistake because God created two people, a man and a woman. And these two people are represented by all the men and all the women. So when Adam ate the apple and Eve ate the apple by Satan, Satan didn't distract just them, he distracted this whole, all this community that are already disbelievers. But God had to bring them out. So now we are being born in the process so that we can now, God can find out who is going to believe and who is not going to believe.
But so our job here is to denounce our crime there. And to
now we have to redeem ourselves. Now we have to show to God that only God is God.
There we go.
Okay, Rashad, alhamdulillah, it's very
perfect. Alhamdulillah, it's perfect. Very okay. Good, now ready to
I have to repeat it. One more, yeah. When God asked Shaitan to prostrate Adam, it was here, but already, already because
it was here.
But he already because the
prostrate means what it means. It means that the angels will serve the human beings. Each one of us has God.
Yeah.
Angels, God in us.
Yeah.
So not a scratch happens without God's will.
Yeah, I understand. But the misunderstanding.
So Satan of course said, I'm not gonna serve the human beings.
Yeah, but the misunderstanding because they said they hear God says prostrate Adam and when okay, go down.
Yes, even the Christians think this is the original sin.
Oh no, the prostration is here.
Yeah, but when God said, okay, if you don't, go down, but he from here didn't go down here because the first one here.
With the second, he created Adam here because, that step is after this. Yes, we have to go in between now. First, he created death, right? When he created death, then he made the body of Adam.
Right here, on the planet Earth.
Yeah, he made the body of Adam and then he gave Adam the name.
So,
what is this place then?
Okay.
This is like a grave for all the humans and the jinns.
Even all the people who are not before born, they are here now.
Before you were born, you were here. Before I was born,
so many people have yet to be born. They are all here.
See this line this waving line? This is where God told Satan to call prostrate, the angels.
Now he created that, right? Now once he created that, then he, out of clay, he made Adam.
Right here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, he made him on earth.
Yes.
Right. And here he gave Adam the name. And he told...
So the body of Adam
was here.
The body of Adam was nothing, like a piece of brick.
Okay,
piece
fine.
Of earth.
Yeah.
The body, this body is nothing.
Okay, so here he asked Satan to fall prostrate in front of Adam.
Yes. First, he got Adam out of here.
Yeah.
Brought him to life.
Right.
Revived him.
Right.
Born. Adam was born.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And Adam was connected with his body.
Right.
Down on earth.
Yeah, the body was
when there. When I went up there to the world of souls, I was connected with my body down in nectar.
Right. Okay? Right.
There was some invisible rope connecting my body to me
up there. Soul. Okay.
Right. The same way Adam was up here and his body was down on earth.
Okay.
And then God told the angels, you are going to serve this human race. You're going to drive the wind to them. You're going to grow the crops and the food. going to guard them?
Yeah.
And they all said, the angels said yes, but Satan said, no way.
So what are the names
what
that we gave
them? No way. Because
the names are the VCR, the TV.
Adam the gave them.
God gave Adam.
The names?
The names, yes.
Names, I don't understand.
The name of what is this?
Oh, he taught him the language.
The name of everything. Think of it as language. Yes.
Okay.
So, the names of all things. And the automobile.
And then Adam told that to the angel.
Well, the God put the angels, gave him a test.
Mm-hmm.
He said, see, there are things I know that you don't know.
Oh, yes. I understand.
And one of the most important things is that God knew that some of us were swept in the crowd.
Okay.
But we didn't deserve to go to hell.
God taught Adam the name. Yes, that means he taught him about the universe, about the earth. And then when the angels came, he gave them the name. And the angels fell prostrate because God told them to, but also because Adam had knowledge.
Yes, that God gave Adam certain knowledge. In other words, the angels realized that some of us deserve to be saved.
Okay, good.
Deserve to be redeemed. Okay,
and this is also second of the sin of the Satan too, because the first he said that he can be the God beside God.
Right here.
Yeah, here. And the second one, God said prostrate, and he didn't prostrate. Right.
Yeah, this time.
Yeah, this time.
And so at all that time,
they go down.
Otherwise, he continued to be a rebel.
Yeah,
This is why Adam was redeemed, but Satan was not. Because Adam said, please God, I made a mistake, forgive me. But Satan continued to think, he still thinks that he can be a God.
Yeah, and we did not...
He still thinks that he can solve this.
Yeah.
But the things are getting out of hand. For example, look at AIDS.
No.
Yeah.
200 years ago, there was no AIDS. Where did AIDS come from?
He created the earth after
his things are getting out of hand as far as Satan's concerned.
So we did not witness
AIDS. Because he's trying to rule this world without any diseases or problems.
He created that. So we did not witness our creation. The angels have witnessed the creation.
Yeah.
The angels, the mountains, and the animals, they all witnessed creation, but we and the jinns did not witness.
Because we were in the
creation of this universe?
Yeah.
Well, actually nobody did.
But I thought the angels witnessed the creation.
Some of the angels participated in some of the creation. But you see, if you look, I want to read this. Don't be frustrated now. You have to learn everything at once.
Yeah, what do you mean? Because we were before dead, we were alive, and God put us to
death. No, but see, about the creation of the universe.
The creation of the universe.
Oh, seven universes.
Yeah,
seven universes.
Okay. We didn't witness the creation. But that I know, but I thought that the angels witnessed the creation.
Wow.
I never permitted them to witness this. I know. This I told you.
Yes.
I never permitted them to witness the creation of the heavens and the earth, nor the creation of themselves.
Yes.
Nor do I permit the wicked to be members of my kingdom.
Right.
Yeah, but.
Talk about Satan. Yeah, this
no, but I am talking about the angels witnessed the creation.
Some of them.
Only some of them?
Yes.
Very
so they participated. Very. In
it. Why not all?
Because what is God, who is God talking about here?
Us. I never permitted them to. No. We said to the angel, okay, let me, my goodness.
Yes.
We said to the angel, fall prostrate before Adam.
Yes.
Huh? Mm-hmm. I have to read it slowly. Yes. They fell prostrate except Satan.
Mm-hmm.
He became a jinn, for he disobeyed the order of his Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Will you choose him and his descendants as lords instead of me? Even though they are your enemies. What a miserable substitute.
Okay.
Okay.
I never
permitted them to witness.
Stop. Who are
them? He means we said to the angels that were your...
Who are them? Yeah.
Everyone.
No. Go back. See?
He became a jinn for he disobeyed the order of his Lord. So, Will you choose him and his descendants? Okay, yes. I never permitted them. So these are the jinns and his descendants.
There you go.
Descendants.
Yes.
I never permitted them to witness the creation of the heavens and the earth, nor the creation of themselves. No. Oh, but I...
Especially that God goes and says, no,
do I permit the wicked to remember
God is talking about him and his descendants.
But did we witness creation?
No, we didn't either.
So the angels, how are you...
Some of the angels participated in the creation process because of the statement, we created.
Yeah.
When God says we, plural, means the angels participated. When God says I created, which means nobody else participated.
But maybe the we means different angels at different times. Right?
Yes.
I mean, when he says we, it might be 10 billion angels in this we, 10 billion angels in another verse we. You understand me?
Yes.
So that might
encompass.
Right?
Yes.
So it can encompass all the angels.
No. So there are so many of them.
Yeah, so they witness different parts.
And it's not
of
necessary. There are so many trillions.
It's immaterial. Really, it doesn't help me.
You're right. But I wanted to know that Satan and his and the jinn did not witness any creation.
Yeah.
What kept it from them? Because that's singular. I never permitted them to witness. And God is talking specifically about Satan and his descendants.
It's too beautiful.
Yeah. Hmm? No, it isn't. But I just worry that you may generalize beyond.
No, I won't.
Beyond the truth.
No, I won't. Okay. I tend to, but I won't.
No, it's a matter of, you're a scientist.
Yeah.
Being an MD, you're a scientist. So I'm watching your statement and I'm trying to make them scientific.
Yeah. Also, I should not talk beyond the Quran. I should talk exactly
the Quran.
Yeah.
Any time we talk beyond the Quran, likely will go wrong.
Yeah, I cannot do that. Okay, so
let's go on with that.
Yeah.
So now we got the sequence of that. Okay, let me go back to 66. We didn't finish even the page.
I know.
Yeah, absolutely. To God belongs everyone in the heaven and everyone on earth. Those who set up idols besides God are really following nothing. They only follow conjecture. They only guess. So when people, in the newspaper everywhere, you see people thanking St. Jude for the success of the surgery. Have you seen that?
Uh-huh.
St. Jude is the health saint.
Oh, the saint of health.
Right. And so God is saying here, they were really idolizing nothing because St. Jude is dead, powerless, he knows nothing about the surgery, never heard of it, and probably St. Jude himself never existed.
Yeah.
Some of those saints are fictional. We find out now.
That is the thing.
Okay, so those who set up idols besides God are really following nothing. So even if St. Jude is alive, he has no power over the surgery that he's doing.
Yeah.
He has nothing to do with it.
Yeah.
So they are following nothing. They only follow conjecture. They only guess. He is the one who rendered the night for your rest and rendered the day lighted. These are proofs for people who can hear.
Mm-hmm.
When you think of night and day, what are we talking about? We're talking about the planet Earth hanging in space and rotating like this, so the sunlight creates day and night. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm getting a lot of shocks and feeling. I'm feeling so bad that I created the mistake. I feel
Which like mistake?
This mistake.
Oh, I see.
I don't want to be in this world because I'm so mad.
Aren't you glad you're giving it a chance to do that? This is exactly why God brought you here.
Getting too much to me.
Yeah, so you can denounce. You're denouncing it now.
I am so shocked at these human people who are not realizing His presence.
Yes. This was one phone call. I have to send you the video.
Not realizing it.
I have to send you the video of this. One phone call 3 weeks back. The title was How Bad the Human Being Is and How Fortunate We Are.
I want to go on the streets and shout. Listen to God. Listen to God.
Yeah.
I want to tell my mother that listen to God.
Wake up. Cool down.
Your aunt is worried about you.
My mother is
See what I'm telling her? Cool down.
Cool down.
But I am not mad. I am so stable.
No, I am not thinking anything. I have to know.
No, but for me, I am so excited for me.
That's why I am listening.
She's just too enthusiastic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. She is always, I am telling, she is enthusiastic, whatever the question is. Not only today.
Yeah.
She is always.
No, but not
this
today.
Is the big one.
This is a big shock. This is a big shock, maybe. She had so many shocks before.
Yeah.
This is the fantastic realization. Especially it comes with the proof. So, but I'm telling her to cool down.
Yeah. That's you had to make her.
Yes.
Then
listen, God tell you that you have to be cool down.
Calm down.
But cool down doesn't mean that I cannot. I shouldn't go out.
Not your mind. Relax.
Cool down for myself, so I feel better about
it. Yes. Yeah. When you talk, relax.
But not everybody is as enthusiastic as you.
You shouldn't be emotional in talking and everything. Then there will be mistakes.
Yes. Yeah. Exactly.
You have to calm down and slowly. You have to teach people. Then only.
Yes.
They will.
You know exactly what you want, only more effectively.
Yeah.
Calm down, there's a very good thing.
Yeah.
Calm down and
I was exactly like you.
Really? Oh, exactly.
Yeah. How long now? Huh? How long it took you? 3-4 years, my God!
Now I'm relaxed.
3-4 years.
Yeah, I was really high. No. Yeah. I went
too.
As soon as I came back.
You want
from
to go on the streets and
me too. All the time the saying, you know what's happened. Every time, you know,
me too.
I went to my neighbor is the Jewish and say, you know what's happened? You are saying,
Listen, you're gonna laugh at this.
Yeah.
Somebody is in the street lost about the address and they come and knock on her door. Is this where Mr. So and So the person come in? Do you know that God sent a message of my message? And we now have proof. That tells us that where we're going wrong and how we can correct it and how we go to heaven. The woman is coming to ask about an address. And this happened when I was there.
I'm doing the same thing.
How do you think Naoko is here? Why do you think Naoko is here? We were going in the same class studying English.
Yeah.
And Naoko came to say, how do you say this word, for example? And he said, did you know that God sent a message? And Naoko said, what?
Yeah,
said,
but
God sent a message that mathematically coded. Naoko said, really? What is that? Said, come to my house.
And at that time, we couldn't talk even English.
Right.
Because it was very low class in English. We couldn't talk in English, but we understand each other.
And I bear witness to this. Naoko didn't know English and Parivash didn't know English.
Yeah, housekeeper, she don't know any English.
Yes,
but we are trying our best to contact with her.
Okay.
If you want, God wants.
Yeah.
Yeah, but
because the heart is good, we can communicate.
So there's nothing wrong with you. In fact, there's something right with you.
My mother keeps telling me and my husband keeps telling me that I have to contain myself. I shouldn't talk about this to anybody. I have to do it only to myself.
Yes.
And I should, you know, actually my husband doesn't want to see any of this.
You need not create enemies.
Yes.
Going and telling
disbelievers
who argue with you. Just tell them.
Yeah. Just tell
whether
them.
They believe or not, that is God.
Yeah.
God's will.
Just tell them.
You shouldn't force them.
But Ramesh tells me I cannot talk to anybody. He says I shouldn't talk. He says
not.
He says
talking,
you should become. Yeah.
Don't,
he told
don't,
me.
Don't start and create problems like you talk to your friend with her, and she is against
but
you.
But I
like
didn't
that.
Talk badly to her. That is the problem. I just gave her the book.
Yes.
And she got upset.
Right.
I just gave her only the book.
But you were arguing about these matters and she got upset and Kamran got upset.
I never argued with her. God is my witness. I know, but I never argued with
her. I believe that because it happens frequently. Sometimes you're just giving the message
just
very
giving
quietly
the book,
and very nicely and it become up and out.
Even though I don't know you before, I was telling her.
I don't know him too.
Be calm down and teach them whatever you know. Let them listen or not, that's not your business.
But
isn't
but
it?
What I'm saying is sometimes
the soil
you can't
is, when the soil is fertile, the seed will grow.
Yes.
The seed will germinate.
I want to know this myself. Sometimes I'm just in the gentlest possible way. I just give him the message and they become terribly upset.
Yeah.
He's telling even if you talk nicely, people sometimes they are
so but you should be like that. You are a messenger, that's why. You should be calm and still you should have patience.
How do I know how he was? Maybe 20 years ago he would scream at them. I don't know. Much time for patience for him. 20 years, maybe 20 years from now, I will be.
That means there is some weakness in the messenger.
Right? There is time and he will become a messenger and become a good messenger.
Even people listening and all those, it is their capacity
but
to
I want to reach the majority. I want us to reach the majority. And I think a better way than to hand out this book is taking
first,
too much
first
time.
You're doing very good with those comments.
That's
what
you
that's
have also I want,
yes,
like, excuse me. Yeah. And also I want, first you refine yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Calm down. Leave the anger and everything. Unless you do those things first, you cannot preach or you cannot tell people.
Mm-hmm.
You should be the one that shows an example, isn't it? If
right,
somebody questions,
see, like
somebody criticizes, oh, Shakira is doing like that, but she is preaching like this. It shouldn't be like that.
No, did
but
you notice what you said?
What
she did was give them
Muslim,
the
good
the book.
Person. You said good person is enough.
I'm a bad person.
Shakira, you know, what they feel, it's the ego again.
Yeah.
Where you were telling them that everything you were doing was wrong.
Yeah.
To me, everything mm-hmm. I was doing was
yeah,
wrong.
Yeah, that's what Kriya said.
But she can be, no, but she can be very diplomatic and mm-hmm. very nice, and this will still happen. You just show them this, and it says, for example, the first pillar of Islam is I bear witness that God is the only God. Now, the Muslims in 1400 years, they added, and I bear witness that Muhammad is his messenger. The Quran says that this is idolatry. You should not put any name next to God. So, what she's telling her mother is that the first pillar that you've been practicing is wrong. And this gets them all upset. And she can do this in the nicest way.
I have done it in the nicest way.
Yeah.
I am nice to them.
But still upsets them because all of a sudden they realize that all their life have been doing something wrong.
I'm talking nicely on
and they don't take it in a nice way.
I have changed so much. Really, I have changed.
Yes.
But what is happening is that even if I am talking to them in the nicest way, they still are being mean to me because they think
not
that I'm
mean.
Doing.
You,
yes,
you want
my mother is
suddenly
mean
to change
me.
Them.
No, I don't want to change
because
them.
You change.
They blame me for everything.
No,
I want to suddenly change them.
Yeah, but nature is you can believe
no,
whatever you believe suddenly.
No, my nature has nothing to
but
do
but everybody
with
are not
anymore.
So fast.
Yes.
You shouldn't get angry with
I
them.
I am not getting angry with them. They are getting angry with me.
Yeah, that is also true.
I am not getting angry with them.
But
they are getting angry with me.
That doesn't matter.
I know
but
it doesn't
matter.
Matter
if they get angry with you.
Yeah.
But you have to be composed and you have
I
to explain.
I am composed.
If they don't listen, that is their fate.
What is happening
that
is that
fate.
They are being mean to
actually,
me. And they are being rude to me. But then they are again turning around
but
and
maybe,
telling
but
me that I have to be good when I am being
But maybe
good.
This verse is for you, that this is not time that the believers give up the disbeliever. And if you read this, the one saying, it's a time for...
Right,
this
so
the,
she knows
you give
perfectly.
Yeah. But they were not, to me, I know Rashad Sahib is telling me, but to me the verse, the believers becoming disbelievers, we were going to ask him that one. They were not believers to start with, because even though they are people of the scripture, that mashallah, I hope inshallah my mother will be guided, but let me take my mother for an example. If they are talking about her, then if the believer, if she's a believer, then she became a disbeliever. But how can she be a believer when she is already doing everything wrong? How can she be a believer?
Is,
you can describe her as a people of the scripture.
Surah 27, 23 and 27 and 29.
Okay,
but
Surah
27. Let me tell you first before you look at that.
Okay.
Your mother sincerely believes in God.
Sincerely, believe me, she believes in God.
Yes.
She talks only of one God.
Absolutely no question about
it. No question.
Yes. So, well, let's look at
it. Yes, I totally agree with that. My goodness, she believes in God and loves Him so much, mashallah. Only with one little fault. I don't know, little. Only one fault.
Here's one of them. This
God.
Right. They will say
to God.
Say,
why
then
do you not take
heed?
She says, I am taking heed.
No, she's not taking heed. It doesn't matter what she says. If she's not doing the shahada correct, she's not taking
this
heed.
This one, when
but
I
this is what you, this
not
what you say.
The
key? Say.
No, she's not taking heed
because
if,
the Quran,
if you
God
ask
says,
her, if you ask somebody,
God says, your testimony shall be, I testify that God alone is God. This is it. But they don't do that. Her mother, my mother, I think my mother changed, but my father didn't. My father wouldn't say, only God is God. He'll say, only God is God and Muhammad is his messenger.
His witness. Yeah.
So they put Muhammad next to God. And this is going against the Quran.
Only one doubt I have. If you pray to God, if you submit to God, we can pray in the name of God.
Yes.
But it helps human beings in such a way that through somebody that we know,
this is the whole idea.
Yeah. But up to now, God kept quiet.
Don't go any further.
Yeah.
This is, you put your finger now on our problem.
Mm.
Our problem is, we think that through somebody, we can go to
we
God.
We did, up to now.
God doesn't want us to do that. God wants us to deal directly with Him.
But no the Bible, it was said through Jesus,
no.
You will redeem your sins through Jesus, because he shed the blood for the human being.
Not through Jesus. Maybe as a teacher, maybe. But Jesus himself said, you forget any other entity and you deal directly with God.
He also said.
Yes.
Yeah, but later they started this.
That's right. It's because of Satan. So Satan gives us his message.
But there is nothing wrong through him if we pray God. Final is final.
Yes, there is something
final.
Wrong.
Yes. Why? What? Wrong. What?
But because God wants us to be devoted to him alone.
But see, there will be bear if you pray to God, name, nothing.
Right.
That is the last stage, I know. But before that last stage, we should have something to concentrate our minds in goodness.
Looks
in
like good we
people
do it.
Or goodness.
Looks
or
like we all do that. In the beginning, we all go through some other person.
Yeah.
But that's wrong.
That is other person means because we believe in the human beings, he is born. And we know that our ancestors saw Jesus, let me tell Jesus, saw him, and he is a perfect man. Our ancestors are telling, that's why we are respecting him too. And then finally we are praying to God. We pray God. I pray to God, Jehovah. Jehovah, but also add Jesus. We are praying through Jesus, Jehovah. We are praying through Jesus to you.
Yes.
Because he is your son. You sent him as a messenger.
Yeah.
And at that time,
this
prophet. Will, prophet or messenger, whatever.
Yeah. No, this will nullify our work. This
how?
Means we insist because...
How? Because he is a perfect man, we know. Jesus is a perfect man.
No,
he is not perfect.
A perfect man.
How?
He made mistakes.
Why?
Right.
About God,
Jesus said
I am
about
the
God.
Son of God, he said. That is the mistake?
No, people said that he was the son of God.
People, about people forget. About him, what do you say?
If we understand God's greatness, we can see the blasphemy of saying that
but he always
he was
told,
God's son.
Pray to God, I am talking because God gave me these verses and these words or something like that.
Well,
but
see,
he didn't mean...
You know what the first commandment is that Jesus repeated?
Yeah.
It came through Moses and Jesus repeated.
Hmm.
You shall worship God your Lord with all your heart, all your body, all your soul.
Yeah.
Right? You know that commandment.
Yeah.
Okay, if I worship God with all my heart, then there is no room for anybody else.
Yeah. What Jesus did mistake? Moses?
Oh, you mean the mistakes that he did?
Yeah.
As a human being, he made mistakes in his life.
What mistakes?
Let me see. If you read the Bible, it says that one time Jesus fell to his knees and he cried until his tears were like blood and he was asking God to forgive him. So why was he doing this? Because he must have done a mistake or something. He was asking God to forgive him. There are several places in the Bible where Jesus prayed to God for forgiveness.
Because he is a human being and he
has
to explain to the human beings, give me the power and forgive me.
All humans make mistakes, including Jesus.
That's why he prayed,
but if he is perfect,
it doesn't mean that we are...
Even if he is perfect, that's good for him. But what he wanted us to do is to devote ourselves to God alone.
Yeah.
And to forget this through somebody, business. We must deal directly with God.
There's nothing bad I am telling, but for concentration some people may want because they have belief in Jesus because he is born and we know, but our ancestors at least, now we are telling, if we see you perfect and we can follow you.
No, but Jesus is not even aware.
But they will also forget you after your...
He has no power. I hope so. I don't want to have anything to do with me.
Yeah. They will never forget the followers. Shakira will never forget you as a messenger.
As a history,
and
yes.
her children cannot forget.
Well, Reagan was the president of the United States.
But they are not praying
that.
To him alone. Okay, through him, to God only. What is the mistake, I am asking?
The mistake is that we put in somebody...
We are not reducing our concentration. But the path we are choosing, the right path, and then going to God.
Yeah, but you see, your mind, you're not thinking of God alone. You're thinking of God and Jesus. Or God
and Jesus, we are not adding in the same status.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah?
Still, God is not alone.
But through God...
If you invite me to dinner, and you tell me, Rashad, bring your servant with you.
Mm.
You're not looking at my servant as in the same status as me, but still I cannot come to your dinner by myself.
Yeah.
I'm not alone anymore. I still have to bring my servant with me.
It is wrong if you bring your servant to the dinner.
No, but but you see, God says the requirement for you to be redeemed to God's kingdom is to be devoted to God alone. So when you say God and Jesus, then God is not alone. When you say Rashad and his servant, I'm not invited alone. The question is alone, because God says you do be devoted to God alone. So when you do your prayer to God, if you think of Muhammad or Jesus or Mary or the saints.
Muhammad did any mistakes?
It's documented here. Yeah. Muhammad did many mistakes. The mistakes? God tells us this in the Quran also. He even caused a dead person to come back to life by God's power. See, God gave every prophet and every messenger certain signs to prove that he is God's messenger. And Jesus' signs was that he healed the sick and revived even the dead, brought him back to life.
It is true.
But this is not Jesus' power, it's God's power.
But Jesus didn't get up from the dead.
No, Jesus is dead.
But then how come people start saying Christ is in
the glory after he was
resurrected?
Yeah. But in some scriptures,
no, he has not
risen.
Then they do
it
in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
No, that's wrong, yeah.
They do that every time.
Yes.
Holy Spirit means our own.
Yeah, that is wrong.
Our own spirit. Holy Spirit.
Yes.
For no, Son, God, Son, and Holy Spirit means that is our soul.
No, they think of the Holy Spirit as the inspiration that comes from God.
Yeah, for everybody, the inspiration comes through us.
Yes.
That is the spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Every religion says that.
Yes.
Through this religion only you will go.
We don't say it here.
Hmm?
Not here.
Yeah.
This is anyone who is devoted to God. That's why I made it the theme of this translation here.
I hope you would have composed this. Joining all the religions.
Yes, this is exactly what I'm doing.
But you are telling don't pray to Prophet Muhammad and don't pray to Jesus. We are praying through them to God, not praying directly to them.
No, God doesn't want that. They don't want that. Mm. Muhammad and Jesus, they don't want us to pray through them. They don't, because it's very clear.
But you cannot compose all these religions as one religion.
Yes.
They are getting against because they are used to for 14.
God will do that. God will unite them into one religion.
There are so many religions.
Yes.
For my question, I am telling.
Yes.
I can't read Arabic or.
Right.
I can read.
Let us take 10 religions.
Hmm.
Okay. Islam, Christianity, Judaism, Hinduism, Buddhism, Zoroastrianism.
Hmm.
Mormon,
yeah,
and so on.
Mm.
What do they have in common that unites all of them?
Oh, those principles that God spread.
But there is one thing in common.
That is common. In every religion it is common.
Which
but the ways and means they are praying to God are different.
Exactly. So the one thing they have in common
is
God.
The
one thing they have in common is God.
Yeah.
All of them worship
prayer,
God.
Prayer, God, and everything.
Right.
Submission.
Right.
Perfect people are submitting in all the religions. They are truthfully they are praying whatever they believe.
Right. So why are they fighting with each other?
Yeah. That is all men created.
Exactly.
People
created. Right. So the
all these religions and all that.
The differences are the men.
Hmm.
These are the differences.
But I think
because the Christians,
why not people But they are fighting, I know.
Yes, I'm answering your question. Mm. It is the answer to your question.
Yeah.
All these religions, the 10 of them, they have one thing in common, and that is God. Mm. All of them worship God.
Yeah.
Once they move away from God to the human factor, they become the enemies.
Mm.
Because the Muslims say Muhammad is better than Jesus,
yeah,
and the Christians say Jesus is better than Muhammad. Yeah. Mm. Then they start to be different. Now, if they forget Jesus and Muhammad and concentrate on the one common thing, which is God, they'll be united. And this is exactly how God is going to do it in the next 100 years.
Yeah, that is perfectly, I believe in that.
Right.
I believe in that when that time comes. I believe in that.
God willing.
But all the way there are so many problems because those people are entirely fixed to that religion. These people are entirely established.
But now, do you know why they are so much
time for them to establish like that.
Yes.
That is, why should God do like that?
Because
it is not a human being's mistake. They are following their ancestors.
Right.
Their ancestors taught him.
We should not follow our ancestors.
Mm. But God gave the chance to do that.
No, but God is telling them here,
yeah,
do not follow your ancestors.
Yeah, then
it says, use your own mind and devote yourself to God alone. If you pray through Jesus and I pray through Muhammad, then it was different.
But my son is there. Maybe he prays in his own God.
Yes.
No name, okay. Nothing. He doesn't believe in any.
If he is praying to God alone,
yeah,
you pray to God alone,
yeah,
not through anybody,
yeah,
and then praying to God alone, there will be no difference between us.
Yeah, but you
but
have.
If you pray,
but if he is not coming out and preaching and telling people like that, is it a sin? Is it
no,
a sin?
Not the same.
No, it
but,
is not.
But it's not as much credit.
Yeah.
Not as
but
much
God
credit.
Knows and he knows,
yes,
what credit God gives him. He,
yes,
wants that much credit only and he is serving the people as a doctor. He is serving the people as a doctor.
Mm.
That is his duty, he is thinking. And he is praying to God directly. What about this?
But it is not wrong to tell the people to worship God,
yeah,
either.
Hmm?
It's not wrong to tell the people, try to save their souls, not just their bodies.
Yeah,
the soul is more important than the body.
But about some people like this, there are.
Mm.
Do you think that they are doing sin? You have to compromise with him because there is nothing wrong with him.
With who?
With my son, I am telling,
yes,
an example.
Oh, I'm
he is
sure
serving the human beings as a profession.
Yes.
He is
yes,
graduated and he wants to do that job perfectly.
Yes.
Nothing
wrong with
he
that.
He devotes much time for that job,
yes,
because God created him like that,
yes,
and he wants to do that job.
Mm.
He thinks like that. Let me do this perfectly and let me pray to God.
Mm.
That's all he is doing.
There
is nothing
wrong
with
that. Yeah.
Yeah, she should compromise with him and she has to be nice with him and
Yes, absolutely. I was telling
but
him this morning.
Why he is telling don't create problems to the family, is it wrong? Is it wrong in telling
no,
her?
No, it is wrong to create problems.
Yeah.
Yes.
He is telling.
Right.
That's what he is telling. Already we
yes,
had problems before. And you are starting this telling people who are friendly to you so much. And they are all getting against.
Because she loves them.
Hmm?
She loves them. She wants them. She wants to save their souls. Because you see,
she should think of her husband too.
Yes.
First, she should think
yes,
of her
definitely,
husband first, and then think of the society later. First,
right,